When the ANC has entered the final phase of our march to a decisive electoral victory on the 3rd of August 2010, the ANC has been on the ground interacting with our people in all areas where we have been. Our people have warmly received the ANC. We are now in the final countdown to the election day and call on all South Africans to vote ANC on the 3rd of August 2016. No one must stay at home confident of an ANC victory. We must all make our mark. Branches of the ANC must provide support to all those who will need to make special votes and ensure that all eligible voters are assisted when necessary to come out and cast their vote. The ANC further calls on all our structures and supporters to resist any provocation during campaigning and continue to work for a peaceful, free and fair election. That is what we decided on. On the recent development on SABC, we thought that it was necessary to remind everybody that the media charter of the ANC found in the Ready to Govern of 1992 affirmed the fundamental principle that ANC will create an open society characterized by the free flow of information and culture of open debate within the context of a democratic constitution and a Bill of Rights. It further identifies that the core democracy lies in the recognition of rights of citizens to partake in society decision-making progress, requiring that individuals are armed with necessary information. That document makes the point that an ignorant society cannot be democratic, and that there shall be no institutional legislation and legislative measures restricting the free flow of information or imposing censorship over the media. The ANC Media Charter further protects media workers against intimidation and other forms of pressure which inhibit their work. This has formed and remains the principle of the ANC's policy on press freedom and the right of all our people have to access information. Successive conferences of the ANC have reaffirmed this position, and among others, resolution of the ANC was a call to increase in local content across all SABC stations. So the current debate is not about the 90% local content. It has nothing to do with that. This debate has nothing to do with that. The 53rd National Conference identified a series of crises at the public broadcaster that reflect a lack of leadership, lack of accountability, and poor management, with National General Council held in 2015, noting a public broadcasting system beset by many structural, managerial, and funding problems that needs to be restructured and repositioned to prioritize public service. That is what we noted in the General Council last year. It is against this background that the National Working Committee received a report from an earlier meeting of the Communications Subcommittee on recent developments at SABC. The National Working Committee, let me add here that in the Sowetan today, the headline says, the minister defies the ANC. I don't know if there is a minister who defies the ANC. The minister referred to in that article is a member of that committee. Now, if the absence in a committee you serve in is equal to defiance, I don't understand the term defiance. She's a member of that committee. There was a meeting of that committee yesterday, and every member was expected to be there. And if any of the members doesn't turn out, it's not defiance. It's a member of a committee who have not turned up for a meeting, of which she is a member. I thought it is important to clarify that, because if we don't, we have this artificial fight of that structure and the ANC this and ANC that. There's no fight over this issue. That's why we're clarifying the ANC policy position on the matter. The National Working Committee reaffirmed the correctness of the Communication Subcommittee position against any form of censorship being imposed at the SABC. It further welcomed the ruling of the Independent Communication Authority of South Africa, ICASA. Matters relating to corporate governance challenges in the institution and the high turnover of CEOs, among others, will be receiving agenda attention. The ANC Parliamentary Caucus is also expected to give the SABC the requisite attention. ANC is calling on all our structures to desist from making any further comments on matters relating to SABC. We've noted that every body in the ANC now stand up and say, this is the position. No, this is the official position of the ANC. No other individual or structure of the ANC should be making any statement. Anybody who does that is making an individual statement and is actually causing confusion among the structures of the ANC and members of the ANC in the first and foremost, and society in general. A report on Integrity Commission, the national officials received a report of the Integrity Commission which was tabled for noting to the NWC. The report has recommended that the matter concerning Comrade Marius Marman be referred to the ANC National Disciplinary Committee, and this has been accepted. A development within, so in other words, we read a report on the City Press on Sunday, which was claiming some findings of the Integrity Commission. The report we have received doesn't contain anything that was reported by the City Press. Developments within Southern African Development Community, the SADC. The National Working Committee of the ANC expressed concern about the recent upsurge of destabilization activities in Zimbabwe and Mozambique. These activities follow the assessment we've earlier made as liberation movements of the sponsored elements seeking to effect a regime change in the region. We think that what is happening in Zimbabwe is part of that program. The upset of the activity of RENAMO in Mozambique is part of that problem. That is the end of our statement. Thank you very much.
Thank you, SG. You can see that the statement was quite short and brief. The SG wants to hit the road. It's going to one of the most remote areas in the Northern Cape. It's only reachable by road. So it's got about 10 hours to drive from now. So if you can just consider that as you can ask questions. Wait, Musi. Wait, Nati. It's off. Okay. I think you're audible enough.
All right. Musi Chimonga from the SABC, you say that the Minister of Communications was not in compliance by not attending that meeting yesterday. What exactly did she say? Did she give an excuse about why she was not in attendance, and what was that excuse?
Okay. I saw Karin.
Karin, you can see I'm writing for News 24. So, Natasha, I have three questions. One's about the elections. The ANC's recently rolled out a big advertising campaign at the airports in the country. Can you maybe tell me what that's about? I've just had a friend, picked up a friend this morning from the airport remarking the whole airport is ANC. And how do you afford that? It must be very expensive. The second question is about Zim, the regime change.
No, we want to paint the independent ears in South Africa.
You'll get into trouble for that. Two questions about Zim. You're saying that there are regime change elements, but you didn't say anything about the economy. In your assessment, is it true that Zimbabwe's economy is suffering at the moment? And what can South Africa do to help? Or what are we doing anything to help in the ANC's view? What can we do to help? And South Sudan, the deputy president was mediating in South Sudan even while he was still with the ANC and before he was in government. And I believe that, there's something fighting between the SPLA factions there. Can you perhaps just remark what the ANC, what the thoughts of the ANC about South Sudan, what can be done there? Will the party get involved as well again?
Okay. Buntu Williams, NN7, sir. The two questions. One is a small matter of the SABC. When I read a lot of the reports today, everyone seems to point that SABC remains defiant, that they intend to appeal the ICASA findings and so on. And I wonder if the ANC has a reaction to that. The second one is also refers to the elections. There have been several surveys, and NS7 has done its own. I think TNA has also done their own. That there are concerns, about the ANC's ability to hold on to Johannesburg, to Tshwane, as well as Nelson Mandela Bay. And I wonder if you have a reaction to that.
May I ask the following, hence, if possible, to not ask as many as two or three questions, maybe one question. Tandabanda, I know you can do that very well. Okay.
Rich Butler from Daily Maverick. As a Liberation Party, is it not sort of incumbent on the ANC to ask whether perhaps the all of the unrest in Zimbabwe is genuinely people motivated? And perhaps we here in South Africa, and the ANC particularly, have a responsibility to stand in there and perhaps help the people who are on the ground?
Okay. Genevieve? No, before that, Tandabanda.
No, Genevieve, ladies first.
No, Tandabanda. We can't share from there.
But you say that the NWC is resolved to ensure that action will be taken regarding the corporate governance issues at the SABC. What exactly will that involve? Because we're sitting now less than a month away from an election. You have you could maybe say de facto head of the SOE saying that they're not going to heed their castle ruling regarding their policy changes on violent images being broadcast in the national broadcaster. Does there not need to be any speech here from the ANC to ensure that we have a fair and free election, especially with regards to the free dissemination of information of what is happening in the country? It sounds like you're pouring cold water on a very, very serious matter.
Genevieve?
Genevieve Quinch from Business Day. I just want to add to some of the SABC questions. Jackson Temby said last week that the decision taken by the SABC actually went to change the policy. Then you have the SABC CEO yesterday saying no one will dictate to them what to do. Just from the ANC's point on that, and whether the ANC will speak to the CEO. And then on elections, there's been reports of intimidation, etc. We even had the DA leader accuse the ANC of intimidating his father at the weekend. Just the comments on that. And also that apparently the former president, Thabo Mbeki, will also be joining the campaign trail.
SG, let me just take these last hands so that I don't have to bother you.
Kieran Kinane from Independent. When you say that your clean structure should desist from making further statements on the SSP's name, I'm also referring to SSP and Kodaja.
Alliance structures. Is that what you mean? Okay.
As you spoke about instability in Zimbabwe and Mozambique, what about Lesotho? Because I think over the weekend there were some shooting incidents there. There were some shooting incidents in Lesotho, and it's like the focus is now on Zimbabwe, whereas our neighbors here are also having their issues.
We said Zimbabwe and Mozambique.
I'm talking about Lesotho.
Okay.
Let's talk about Lesotho.
He's adding Lesotho.
Okay. All right. And then on Chapter 9 institutions, because yesterday we heard that they just make recommendations, whereas I thought we have moved from recommendations to actually they make decisions, like the issue of the recent Constitutional Court judgment, where it was the public protector was actually affirmed to make decisions, not recommendations. And yesterday, with SABC, it was said, we were just taken back to the issue of recommendations once more. Maybe just as ANC to comment on this one.
It looks like you and Tandabantu, you have been attending a lot of meetings of the SACP. You can't say SAPC, you keep on saying SACP, which is quite good.
Yeah.
I'm done. That was the first and the last rounders, so that I can release you.
I don't know how many of the journalists here have ever been to Richmond and Victoria West, except when you drive from here to Cape Town on N12. We have been there doing some work in Victoria West and Richmond. I'm inviting you to join me there. Okay? That's before the Three Sisters, at the end of the Northern Cape. That's where I'm going.
Towards Beaufort West.
Towards Beaufort West, in the Western Cape. We say there was no defiance. After we're going to continue resisting any temptation to believe that there was resisted defiance, because Togodit is a member of that committee of the ANC. Tulasness is a member of that committee. I can give you a long list of people who are not in that meeting. So what we're going to resist is to isolate one member of that committee, say, this member defied, when there was a number of members of the subcommittee were in that, not in that meeting. So we categorize them the same as people who didn't attend the meeting of the committee. But that did not stop the committee from doing its work. That's why we can report today on the outcome of the meeting of the subcommittee of the NEC of the ANC. Adverts in the airport. When the elections, you get any space that you can lease for advert, whether it is in a billboard or in the airport or anywhere, if we can get space, that's why I was saying jokingly, if we can be allowed by our neighbors here to put up an advert of the ANC and say we charge you a fee, we'll welcome that and put up that advert. That's advertising for elections as part of the campaign. So we'll go to any space that is leased, anywhere, including the airport. If we could get anywhere else where there's a prominent place where people go through in numbers and we get a right to advertise, we would. What do we do to deal with the economy in Zimbabwe? You must appreciate that the economic situation in Zimbabwe has been going on for some time. That's why the dollar, the Zim dollar, got out of circulation. There's no currency in that country. They're using a pound, a rand, a dollar, a pula. If you're there, you buy with any currency you have in Zimbabwe. That reflects the long history of economic difficulties in Zimbabwe. And our view is, if that economy is not assisted to be revived and recover, they will be in trouble there for a long time. But that should never give a license to regime change elements to revive restlessness in Zimbabwe. That's our view. Every citizen of Zimbabwe should appreciate the difficulties and contribute positively in the rebuilding of the economy in Zimbabwe. You know, we normally tell people in South Africa that I was discussing with young students today, and I said to them, I want to take a group of them to some countries in the continent and everywhere else to have a taste of what they protest against here and see the difference. But because they know no more, they think that they are in a worse situation in South Africa, they must go out and visit other countries and compare. I can do that. I've been to many countries. That's why I don't want to go anywhere else. I want to remain a South African. It's a nice place to be in. Now, the question about Zimbabwe is that, what are we going to do with Zimbabwe? We can assist Zimbabwe, but the initiative of rebuilding the economy in Zimbabwe is the responsibility of the Zimbabwean government. It's not our responsibility. We must rebuild ours. We're growing at less than 1%. That is our responsibility, to try and work on the Zimbabwean economy to grow at an acceptable rate. That's our responsibility. But that there are problems in Zimbabwe should never be a license for Zimbabwe to be destabilized. South Sudan, we are interacting with the SPLM in South Sudan, and our call is that if they are at war in perpetuity, they will never have stability. If they don't have stability, they will never build that country. It's a young country, it's a young democracy. It can't be built with a firearm. It can only be built with people being involved in the economic activity there. SABC remaining defiant. You know this term defiant, and you get self-satisfaction in defying. You know, self-satisfaction in defying. After all, I normally say to people, when you do that, you are cutting your nose to spite your face. Because you come back to realize much later that what you were proud of displaying your power by being defiant is actually destroying the institution and you as an individual. So our view is that we're hoping that the people in the SABC will realize that to defy everybody in society doesn't make them a better public broadcaster. It is when they try to listen to what the public view is that makes them a better public broadcaster. And therefore, being proud of being described as defiant and you are a public broadcaster is a contradiction in terms. Surveys. We are following the surveys, whether it is NN7 or anybody else who runs a service, IPSO, Macno, everybody, we follow them. But what we know is that elections are a product of the energy, resources, and work you put into the campaign. That's why sometimes surveys are correct in many areas, but they actually get defied in a number of areas because the work and energy you put into the campaign is actually tampering with those surveys. And if we would look at those surveys and all be demotivated, that hey, there's a risk of losing Tswana aspect, a risk of losing Tswana, of a risk of losing Nelson Mandela, we would all go home and sleep, and the surveys will just become a reality. But our work in those areas will tamper with the surveys. That's our understanding. Unrest in Zimbabwe being genuine, and whether we should not side with the poor, we should side with everybody. The poor can be better in a stable Zimbabwe. The poor will never improve their reality if Zimbabwe is destabilized. So we'll never support destabilization of Zimbabwe because we think that it is in solidarity with the poor. It is not. If you destabilize Zimbabwe, you are pushing the poor deeper into abject poverty. And therefore, our call is that Zimbabwe must be allowed to make all its effort to stabilize itself so that the poor can be able to benefit and be taken out of abject poverty. Corporate governance in the SABC. Dissemination of information is important. An ignorant society cannot be a democratic society. A society that has information is empowered to take decisions that are based on the information. No one can dictate to the SABC what to do. Actually, it's a very mistaken position. It's a public broadcaster. There is a shareholder ministry. It should be managed at that level. There is a committee in parliament that deals with that. If there's an institution that says in society it is a bull in a Chinese shop that can break everything and think that it is doing the right thing, I think that somebody must whisper in the ear of the leadership in the SABC to appreciate that they can't be a bull in a Chinese shop that cannot be tempered by anybody. It can't be. Daily they're complaining, I'm leaving this to Ziz, I think my man is more at the level of this in terms of age. I'm too old to deal with my man. You know, this morning there is a picture being circulated of the metropolis in Cape Town branding certain vehicles on a TA campaign slogan. And I don't know why is there nobody who takes that up, because if it was the ANC, I can tell you now, it would be a major issue. Why are metropolis in Joburg branding their vehicles in ANC cab? Everybody would be asking that, but in Cape Town, everybody is quiet about it. I don't know what is unique about Comrade Thabo Mbeki campaigning. As a member of the ANC, campaigning is the right thing to do for any member of the ANC. So I don't know what is newsworthy in him campaigning. All members of the ANC are expected to campaign. Those who can't, who accept that they can't, whatever the problems are, but the expectation is that any member of the ANC should campaign for the ANC. What about Lesotho? Lesotho case is a special case of the SADC, Troika. They're dealing with that. That's why we're not mentioning the shootings and gunfire shots in Lesotho are almost the new normal. So it's not that we're underplaying the situation in Lesotho, but we're talking of the upsurge of destabilization in Mozambique and Zimbabwe. Chapter 9 institutions, ICASA is a Chapter 9 institution. It has the authority to make certain decisions. If you defy those decisions, I can tell you that you will learn a hard lesson. You defy those decisions of a Chapter 9 institution, you will learn hard. That's the advice we can give to the SABC.
On the question of intimidation of my man's father, he is guilty of stealing Nelson Mandela, the president of the ANC. You can imagine how the children and grandchildren of President Nelson Mandela feel when my man uses his name, when in fact he only complains about the ANC going to the house of his father just to talk to him as part of campaigning. So we are quite shocked about his overreaction, that he himself is guilty of stealing a father to many people and to his grandchildren. So we think that perhaps he's now testing his medicine when he goes around and raises issues that we will continue to talk to the father like anybody. Fortunately, father is a former member of the ANC. Sometimes when you do door-to-door, you don't know who is in the house, whose house, who's the owner, and so on. You learn when you are inside. You will be then the former secretary of the ANC then. We'll say, have you moved to here as secretary? We'll talk about that.
He's agreeing in Japanese style.
So we'll continue to talk to anybody, including his father. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Mkwati, you are now excused to go to... On what now?
But you can't have a follow-up.
When you didn't ask any question. You can only have a follow-up when you ask a question.
You mentioned something that I just wanted to address.
Okay.
On the question of the elections, you mentioned that the work that the ANC will be doing throughout the country will temporarily various surveys that have been done. Does this work perhaps include the forging of coalitions to retain the heavily contested electorates?
Let me answer that. And then
that's in the appendix.
And then I'm
done.
And then I'm just gonna pass. No. You don't think coalitions, you work for winning elections. Coalitions are a consequence of the outcome of the elections. So we can't sit here now and say we're planning a coalition there and a coalition there. We are working hard enough to win elections in every municipality. So that is not what we say when we say tamper with polls. You tamper with the polls by talking to the people, shifting the undecided to vote for the ANC. Once you do that, you are tampering with the polls. So coalitions is something that is post-elections. It's not now. Thank you very much to everybody. I appreciate your presence.
Thanks very much, members of the media.